I am currently assistant professor in the Department of Psychology and Counseling at Northeastern State University in Broken Arrow, Oklahoma. Developmental psychology is the study of psychological change and constancy across the lifespan. Developmental psychology differs from other areas of psychology in that I kind of view the field as kind of a meta psychological field, in that it kind of spans many of the other areas by studying the developmental progression of those specific areas. For instance, there's cognitive psychology, social psychology, personality psychology, clinical psychology, and all the variables that are studied in those different areas, developmentalists look at as well, but we're more concerned with how are those things developing over time, those different processes and phenomena. Well, my average day is pretty hectic. As a college professor, we're constantly multitasking, and a lot of emails, responding to emails and writing emails to colleagues, students, a lot of meeting with students, and going to committee meetings, working on research projects, preparing for class. And you've probably noticed I haven't even said teaching yet. So there's a lot that goes with it, on top of just teaching, which is, I think, what most people view being a college professor as, is just kind of going, walking into a classroom and lecturing, and then that's it. But there are so many other details involved with that. I am a what we call a social developmental psychologist, specifically, as opposed to like a cognitive developmental psychologist. So I study social processes in particular. I'm really interested in the relationship between family experiences and children and adolescents' social development. So how they get along with their peers, how they do at school, in adolescence, what their romantic relationships are like. And my own specific research has focused in the past couple of years on marital relationships. And I've been looking at how both positive and negative marital relations are associated with children and adolescents' social competence. And right now, I'm working on, with a few colleagues, we are designing a new questionnaire to assess early adolescents' perceptions of positive aspects of their parents' marriage. The way I got involved in this field, well, I was an undergraduate psychology major, and I was drawn to psychology just because I was always a kid who was very interested in how people tick. I did always wonder about how people become who they are. And so that naturally led me to psychology. And it was in my undergraduate training where I discovered this passion for, this field of developmental psychology, which is actually devoted to studying why people become who they are and what factors contribute to that. To be a developmental psychologist, you pretty much do have to get a doctorate in psychology. And so that's going to take anywhere from 4 to 6 years beyond the undergraduate degree. And having a strong background in psychology before graduate school is very important. And so that's, I would recommend that. There are particular skills that are valuable in being a developmental psychologist. And some of those involve being very good at critical thinking and analytical thinking skills, being able to write very well. Something that a lot of people may not realize that is incredibly important for developmental psychologists is quantitative skills. So math skills that can be applied for statistical analysis, that is very common in our research. So communication skills and writing are also fundamental. So those are some of the things that I think would be required for somebody who wanted to pursue developmental psychology as a career. With developmental psychology, I don't really have anything in mind about that. But with regards to being a professor, there are definitely things that I was not aware of. I think I was not aware of the level of service requirements that are expected of professors and clerical work, to be honest, when it comes to things like advising and things like that, which I love to do. But a lot of the service activities, being on committees and things like that, that's not really what I envisioned when I was in a graduate school program trying to get a PhD in developmental psych. I can definitely speak to the types of changes I've seen in my field, and I could talk about changes I've seen in higher education. And many of them have to do with technology, you know? And I think when you look at the classroom, I think we're seeing a tremendous increase in the number of online courses and blended courses that meet sometimes online and part of the time in person. I think that's having a tremendous impact on how higher education just conducts its business. And at the in developmental psychology side of it, and with regards to research, I think technology has played a role there. We've become increasingly sophisticated in our technological advances with regards to especially to statistical analyses and being able to model different types of theoretical frameworks and seeing and to doing examining very complex statistical models. I think that has been a wonderful asset to us as a field because we've got to learn so much more about the complexities of human development. Well, for the future, specifically for developmental psychology, I think this is actually something for that's true of all of psychology, is that where the field is going more and more biological. And I think that's just a function of really realizing, coming to the recognition that we are biological beings and that you can't separate the psychological phenomena that we study from the biological phenomena going on underneath. And so we're learning more and more about that. And with advances in other fields like molecular genetics, we're starting to get a much fuller and more complete understanding of human development. I think that something related to that is an increasing recognition in the field of the dynamic nature of human development. It's not no longer do we believe that there's this kind of static genes versus environment. So I think some of those are some of the things that I think we're going to see in the future. The way I got into it was actually in graduate school. After my first year of graduate school, I was thrown into a class to teach as a teaching assistant, but I was actually teaching the class. Even though I was very nervous, it was a moving experience for me. Once I got up there and you know, and I worked really extra hard to make sure I knew everything, you know, and you never know everything, but I just found that as a teaching assistant that I found my calling. That was something that I loved. I knew I loved reading and studying psychology, in particular developmental psychology. At that point, though, I didn't know that I loved teaching it as well. And that's been something that is it's a major part of not just my professional, I think, but my personal identity too, is being an educator. It's not specific to developmental psychology, but I think it's kind of the, you know, age-old guidance counselor question is that what would you do if you had no, you know, if you had all the money in the world, what would you do? And I always ask my advisees that, you know, when they come in and I tell them, well, what do you think about when you're just on your own, you know? Now some of them say, oh, I think about, you know, movies or TV, you know, but the I think the best set, clearest sign to somebody of that you're in the right field is that if you think about it when you're not forced to. I think it's that kind of intrinsic motivation that would lead to the greatest chance of success in the field and satisfaction with it. So that's something that I think is a critically important question is do you think about this kind of stuff in your own time? Some important traits that I think for this field, our intrinsic motivation. I mean, again, I can't stress enough how important it is that you've got to love what you're doing. Creativity. I think creativity is we often don't think of it in terms of research, but it requires a great amount of creativity and being able to think outside of the box and to be able to think about novel ways of measuring variables and new research questions to explore. You know, passion as well. I think that a field is only as strong as its most passionate leaders. Who is seriously interested in pursuing developmental psychology as a career? I would say learn as much about it as possible, as early as possible, and try to get as much research experience as an undergraduate. I think that's really important because, as I said, most people get a doctorate, and in order to get into those programs, you have to have some research experience as an undergraduate. So I think that would be incredibly valuable.